Okay, I am back with a new video and I'm going to use the heaven and earth because it feels the right thing to do. And I did a couple of short, gentle and nice and friendly and non-threatening healings on your son. And I just want to know, I'm just making this video because I want to know some things. The first thing is that I know you want to connect with your son and want to talk to him, and I'm just going to try find out what he needs and how you can reach him. So the first card is this one, and this is the Nine of Swords, and there is somebody in bed thinking about a lot of things that are troubling and nasty, and so this is you, and you worry too much. You make things too complicated where things are actually quite easy and simple. And it's a funny thing because we often think about telepathy, for example, as something that's very difficult and needs a lot of practice. But you have to remember that there's always a link between people that care about each other. There's always a connection between people that love each other. And your son has a lot of respect for you, and he really wants to, you know, have a relationship and continue the relationship. So all the anxiety and worry and fear and maybe depression and sadness and maybe some nightmares sort of overrule you being able to just talk to your son. It might feel, or it might look like something that you're doing with your mind and that you have a vivid imagination, but right now your imagination plays tricks on you where you are stuck and you feel you aren't capable or able to connect with your son and talk to him and things like that. But if you let this go, then you will feel or sense that he's ready and he's waiting for you. And since he's not here anymore, he has all the time in the world to wait for you to get ready or to be ready or to let go of your worries and just, you know, embrace him and give him a hug and see what you two can talk about. So this is you. You worry too much. And this is something that I just like to do. This is also the same way that I go through a bookstore. I just touch a lot of books, and then at some point I will just feel that a certain book, in this case a card, is the right one. So here we have the Princess of Pentacles, which is actually the Page of Pentacles. And in this case it's a beautiful image of somebody that a woman, in this case normally it's a young man, that holds a staff with a pentacle, and she is in a forest in the wild somewhere alone, and it's a beautiful magical image. It's always a, I don't know, this deck is so super beautiful. So what do you do to talk to your son? It's a skill that needs to be developed. So you need to let go of all your worries. I can't do it. I don't know how I do this. I don't know how to do. I don't know what to say. I don't know if my mind plays tricks on me. Let this go. And there you go. This is your card. It is said to be a skill, but or a talent, or something that you have to practice. But I can talk to you when you are asleep, when you are awake. I can send you a message that says, I love you, or I care about you, or I worry about you. And I can send you light, and I can send you love, and I can send you supporting energies and angelic energies. So don't procrastinate anymore. Don't stop progressing. Keep going, keep trying, and just do it. Believe in yourself, because you can talk to your son. Another thing that you can do is show strength, because this is how your son knows you, as somebody who is very powerful, has a lot of knowledge and a lot of wisdom, and can, you know, conquer the world and, you know, beat evil. And this is you. You are very, very powerful. You're very strong right now. You might feel weak, but you are courageous, you're powerful, you are persuasive, you have a big influence on a lot of people. Your sense of humor and compassion is without boundaries, limitless. So please let go of all those worries and just go for it. Do it. Just talk to your son. And this is what he needs. This is how he knows you. Somebody who is able to tame the beast and show wisdom and a lot of compassion and forgiveness. So this is how I think you should approach your son, and leave all doubts behind and things like that. Another thing is that I feel that, sorry, I have to cry a little bit, and that comes with sniffing. So I feel that your son doesn't want to go to the place that you want to bring him, but that doesn't matter. If it feels right, the right thing to do for you, then you should do it. But I think he's going to stick around for a little bit longer. And it doesn't really matter where he is, with me or in the garden or in heaven or with you, sort of, you know, walking around in the house and in the garden and in the neighborhood. It doesn't really matter. You can always reach out to him, and he's waiting for you. So that's it. See you next time. Bye.